places I can reach. You know that I can use somebody. You know that I can use somebody. Someone like you and all you know and how you speak.
Hi, welcome to the Freeman Show. I'm Lazo Freeman, and we're lucky to have number one trainer from the States who created his own system, training for warriors, Martin Rooney. I mean, we've been hanging out for 4 days. I'm smashed from all the training and the cool stuff that we've been talking about. We've been talking for hours, so like 3 o'clock in the morning. So we thought, you know what? We're going to share something really interesting about the fitness industry and how to get results. So here's Martin Rooney, my man.
Hey, pleasure to be here on the show, and Lazo is right, man. We have covered more training stuff, and one of the things we said last night, I said, Laz, man, we should have had a camera rolling this entire time. When we had a conversation that I wish people could have been sitting in on, and right now we're going to try to replicate some of that, because I believe there's so many important topics that people out there that are interested in fitness, if they could hear these things, it could really set them in the right direction if they did that. And I think the first topic that we really talked about is where people get their information
from. Yeah, and all the misinformation and the vastness of information compared to what we had like 15 years ago and what was the problem that it causes.
Yeah, exactly. Well, one of the things right now is, hey, if we've looked at so much of training and what is going on in training today, whenever I ask, hey, how long have you done this or how long have you done that, most of the things that most people do right now were done in over the last probably 5 or 6 years. And when I started to think about that, hey, how come people aren't doing things from so much longer ago, and you start to realize that, hey, what else came out around this time? And it was kind of the information highway, whether you want to call it the internet, the World Wide Web. As soon as information exploded and information became available to everyone, I believe that it became very difficult for people to filter or decide what information is good, what information is bad, and people became more easily influenced by flash or something new and shiny and cool than it was about producing results. And what's scary about that is what we discovered is, hey, when we talk about training for warriors, I'm here in London sharing the system. We had another 20 people go through the course. It was amazing. And the piece that I've noticed most that people have forgotten about with their clients is that we want to produce results. Our clients are coming to us to lose weight. Our clients are coming to us to build muscle. I mean, those two things are mainly the main things that someone's coming to us for. But as trainers, we've either become so scientific or so eccentric around the piece of equipment that we have, that we've forgotten that it still has to be fun. It still has to be something that produces the results that they're looking for. And that's why I think we're losing the war on obesity and diabetes and cancer. There's so many things that we could be changing as fitness professionals, where I believe, hey, we might not need all the doctors that are out there if we were getting our job done correctly. And that's what I believe, hey, that's my mission now. Training for Warriors is to create this army on the other side of all the problems that are happening and take on some of these huge dilemmas that we have facing human beings today.
And as you said, what are the problems? And the problems, like what Martin was saying yesterday, is not necessarily that everybody knows what they need to do, but they don't have the behavior patterns to do it. And Martin's philosophy, which I've got a lot from, as well as the trainer system itself. And I know trainer systems, I've learned a whole bunch of them, but Martin's is like fucking spot on. Is the coaching side of it all, like, you know, and getting these people to get the right dosages in their training, and everyone's doing the wrong dosage.
Yeah, well, he hit a couple of big things on the head that we were talking about, which is making me remember. One of the ones is it's habits. What do we say? Hey, most people know what to do. They just don't do what they know. So people know how to eat, right? When I poll anyone, I can rip somebody off the street and say, is this good or is this bad? They know. But what they don't do is they don't take action on what they know. People know that exercise is important. They've got to get that. And they know it only takes a couple of hours a week. That's the truth. But then you ask them, can they do it? And they say, no, I'm too busy. Hey, I'll say, how many hours of sleep do you need a night? Every person says 8 hours. And then I say, how many do you get? And people say, well, 5 or 6. So what happens is the world has become busy And I call it the expendable three. Sleep goes first, then exercise out the window. Then when people are really busy, yeah, they can't even eat right either. And what I say is if you can't find enough time in the week to get enough sleep, exercise, and eat right, you're not busy, you're out of your mind. And unfortunately, that's exactly where we're at. So, and why is that? It's habits. People just have the wrong habits. And how do we influence that as fitness professionals? It's not in the 2 hours a week that you have with someone out of 168 and you're worried about fancy equipment. What you've got to do is be able to coach. So this is something that I speak about often all over the world that, hey, there's fitness and you understand science, you understand training, but man, there's an entire science to coaching, how to connect, how to engage, how to get inside someone's head so that in that 166 hours they're not with you, they are actually doing the things you need them to do. They are eating right. They're getting enough sleep. And that is where the results are going to come from. So the breakthrough that we kind of had talking last night is the results don't come from the 2 hours they're with you. The results come from the 166 hours they're not with you, but you've got to do something magic during your session to do that. And that, you know, in my system, that's a huge piece of what we not only share, but coach people how to do and remind them how important that is.
Right, and then you end up cultivating that within them, and that's the whole ethos, is bringing the warrior within. And that's when you get the mindset and you get the feeling like, right, I'm gonna stick to my nutrition plan. And it's not a diet, it's my nutrition plan. I'm gonna stick to it for life, or I'm gonna stick to good sleep, and always stick to the exercise, because you do the exercise, you feel good, the endorphins kick in, right? What I wanna know is like, so why is it like in the fit, we were talking about, going back to the topic of all this information that's out there, and there's so many trainers, they're talking about this exercise, this program, and yet they haven't trained or they don't have any information to back up the results.